well, I want to start off with a certain thing that I do every October 23rd, and I set my alarm for 6:02 in the morning. And a lot of my friends go, why do you do that all the time? And I say, because I think it's such a great number. And literally, I set the alarm 6:02 on October 23rd. And that is when I get up and I do a celebrational dance to a gentleman called Avogadro. He was not only a scientist, but by the way, he was also a lawyer. And he is instrumental in chemistry. So at 6:02 on October 23rd, you'll know by the end of this lesson why I choose those numbers to do my celebrational dance. Anyway, let's try to take a look at reasons why we might need to do calculations. Okay, so for example, the Native American Indians do sand paintings, and so do the Tibetan monks, and they do these beautiful sand paintings. It takes a long time, and then, by the way, when they're done, they just wipe the slate clean. But what if I turned to each of you and I said, for a homework assignment, I'm going to give you this sand painting, and I want you to count every grain of sand used. Well, you'd go, wow, that's going to take a long time, and maybe even like weeks. But I'm going to tell you there's an easier way to do it. And we simply do it by counting the mass. And just like in chemistry, we're not only looking for what is being produced, but how much we need. Okay? So what we're going to talk about today is the mole, Avogadro's number, and molar mass. Okay? So in chemistry, we use the term mole. And a lot of you automatically in your brain think of that furry little animal that digs up the yard, or in Caddyshack, one of my favorite characters in it. But the mole is actually in chemistry a way that we do a number of atoms, molecules, ions, and elements. And it's just basically a way to make a calculation and making it easier. For example, when you're going shopping and your mom tells you to buy 6 dozen eggs, you know how to calculate that to come back with the amount of eggs she wants. And by the way, I'd say to your mom, why do I need so many eggs? But anyway, going on past that, we need to find a way to count atoms, and to help us answer that question, we look at the how much. So the mole, right here, is simply the amount of a substance that contains Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, of particles. And these particles can be anything. They can be molecules, green peas, or my favorite thing, a football. But you'd have to be footballs if we're doing it by Avogadro's number. So here's a familiar example that might help you to think of it. Okay, so let's say, again, we're using your parents again. Your mom sends you out with about, you know, 10 or 20 bags of aluminum cans, okay? And she says, I want you to take this to the recycling center, and I want you to come back with the cash. Okay, where you're going, okay, I'll do that. But when you get there, are you gonna pull each can out and weigh it? No, of course not. There's a simpler way to do it, and that's by using mass. So let's look at this. If I take one can and it has a mass of 10 grams, which is right here, and I have a group of cans that has a mass of 1,000 grams, I'm gonna put it right there, I'm gonna figure out there are 100 cans. It's pretty simple, but I just have to remember that I'm gonna cancel out this right here, and I end up with 100 cans, okay? However, in molar mass, we can count by mass applied to the large quantities of the atoms. So it's absolutely critical when we are doing calculations in chemistry that remember we have to think of some clear steps. When we're using a calculator, I'm going to tell you all, it's absolutely critical that you are very attentive to what buttons you're pushing on the calculator, because in my years of teaching chemistry, I've seen a lot of equations messed up because of that. I'm actually also a really firm believer in graph paper, because then you line all your numbers up. And also, what's super important, that I want you to use the factor labeling method. And to make sure, always check where you place your digit in scientific notation. And you'll find that every 2 weeks, we'll do scientific notation reviews, because that's super important in chemistry. Okay, so now let's look at calculating molar mass for an element. This is actually very, very simple. Okay, so what we're going to use is the molar mass of oxygen. Okay, so I just put O, and I know the molar mass of oxygen is also the molar weight. Okay, and it's 1599. I'm just going to round up to 1600. That will make it easier. Okay, so the molar mass of oxygen, all I'm going to do is look at the periodic table, find the molar weight, or the molecular weight of it, the atomic weight, and then I'm going to go ahead and times it by 1 mole. And that's pretty simple. It's just going to be 1600, okay? So it's a pretty simple equation, but it's going to get a little bit more difficult when we start looking at molar mass in grams and in equaling to molar weight. Okay, so moving past that. For a molecule, however, we have to add up the masses of each of the atoms. So we have to go into a bit more detail in this one. Okay, so in this next unit, we're going to look at that. We're going to go ahead and make sure to write the answer to show the molar mass is always measured in grams per mole. Okay, and for example, if we want to calculate the molar mass of O2, simply we're going to do this. Let me erase the board real quick. So, O2. Okay, so we have the molar mass of O2. We're simply going to go 2 times, because we take that 2 times, whatever our weight is, which is going to be, the molar mass is always the weight, which is going to be 16. Okay, and it just is going to equal, this is a pretty simple equation, 32. And we're going to make sure to put the point right there. Is this equation done? No, absolutely not. We need to make sure we have grams per molecule. Okay, so we need to make sure we put that, or we're going to end up messing up our whole concept. Okay, but now to calculate a molar mass for a compound, we must remember that a mole is defined as the amount of a substance that contains Avogadro's number, which is our 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. Okay, so we have to make sure we use that. So then there are 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of carbon dioxide in 1 mole of gas. So let's try to do that equation right now. So here's why I emphasize, again, the factor labeling method, because it keeps us on track. And we'll want to calculate the number of molecules in 0.75 mole. We would write out a ratio using the factor label method and multiply, okay? So let me erase. I'm gonna take question mark molecules, okay? And what am I looking for now? Of CO2, correct? Okay, and now I have to make sure I put grams. Okay, now I need to write equals 0.75, okay, so we have that down, mole of CO2, and then I'm going to cross over and do times, okay, now I have that. What's going to go up on top? My Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. Is that complete? No, I still have to write molecules, and I'm still not done, of CO2. Sorry, I'm running out of a little space there. Okay, now I have how many? 1 mole, correct, of, what is it? CO2. Good, oops. Now what am I gonna do? I'm gonna multiply, okay? So 0.75 times, what am I gonna multiply it by? The 602. Okay, so that's going to be pretty simple, and we're going to end up with 4 point, we want to make sure our decimals are in the right place, 5 times 10 to the 23rd. Now keep in mind, when we're doing the factoring out, we have to make sure we cross cancel out certain things. And what am I going to cross cancel out? Mole CO2, okay, that's going to be gone, and mole CO2 right there. Okay, so let's move on to moles and a review. Okay, so now, so moles and a review. So molar mass, the mole is the counting unit. And we want to recall that one mole of a compound contains Avogadro's number, which we have down, of the molecular compound. And to find the molar mass of a compound, we're literally going to do three things. We're going to use the chemical formula to determine the number of each of the atoms present in the compound, okay? Number two, we're going to multiply the atomic weight, and we always remember it's the bottom number, the atomic weight, think of weight weighing you down. And third, we're going to add it all together. Okay, so let me erase it. I'm going to show you an example of that. So my formula is right here, Na2CO3, got it? My sodium carbonate. Okay, we're going to put Na, I know it's a 2, so I put it there, times, and I'm going to look at the atomic weight of it. And so I find it on the periodic table, and remember, it's the bottom number. It's what weighs us down. That's how I tell you to remember, it's the bottom number there. So we know that the atomic weight is 23.0, okay? So 2 times that is 46.0. Now I have carbon, and I have 1, okay, times 12.0, because that's the atomic weight of carbon. What weighs that baby down? Okay, equals 12.0. We're not done. We got oxygen. We got oxygen 3, okay? So, times 16, and that was my mistake. See, I could have made a really simple calculation error there. I just remembered that I had 3 that I did not write down. So I caught myself. So make sure when you're doing these that you double check everything. And that's why when you're sitting in your groups doing these, I want everybody to make sure everybody's got the right way. Okay, moving on. So we have that, and then I'm going to times that times 16, and it's going to be 848.0. So I'm gonna add it all together, and guess what? My molar mass, adding it up, is 0. And I really wish I had graph paper, but 6, 0, and then 1. Okay, now where's my digit right there? So 106.0, and that is my complete equation there. And again, remember, catch yourself making sure everything's lined up right, and you're adding up all your numbers correctly and putting the scientific notation correctly down. Okay, so now moving on. And we will review this quite a bit, because these can be difficult to do.